Welcome to episode 28. I feel like I start a lot of my episodes in this spot, but I guess it's just a good place to AFK when I'm editing the episodes and stuff. So the main plan for this episode is going to be to get a black mask and do as many hard clue scrolls while getting the black mask, and then imbue it at the end. I'll probably do some other stuff after that, but I don't exactly know what I want to do. Like, I obviously got to glory last episode, and I could start Slayer again, which would be pretty nice. 74 fishing, that's pretty nice as well. Or I might do some other stats. I'm not entirely sure what I want to do. I just definitely know I want to get a black mask out of the way. So that's going to be the first thing I do this episode. So I'll come back probably at Cave Horrors. So I'm still fishing, but I just got a hard clue bottle. So I guess I'll do this before I go to Cave Horrors. So that's pretty nice. Tenderloin, cannot complain. Oh wow, casket already. It's hell good. Okay, I'm also going to do a farm run for this one up here, but let's have a look at the casket. Oh wait, do I have room? You know what, I'll just quickly do this farm run, and then I'll open it in a bank. Oh, that's pretty good. I actually did need a prayer bonus chaps, and I was going to do firekeep this episode as well, so that definitely is good. I'm pretty sure they have the exact same as Black Dehyde, right? It's just extra prayer bonus. So range 47... Yep, everything's the exact same except prayer. Okay, that's actually really good. That is something I needed. So what do you know? Okay. Okay, so it's finally time to start killing Cave Horrors. And now I think this is probably the quickest way for me to get there. If not, I will just use Ecto Funkus Teleport and travel by Bill. But I think this brings me here. So I will now get to the cave and start killing them. Just about to hit 75 range, which is pretty nice. I haven't killed too many, like maybe 50 or so. But I'll probably do a bank. I'll probably bank all this and come back. When I do get the black mask, I'll check from the Slayer gem how many I kill. But I don't really mind how long it takes. I mean, as long as I don't get into the thousands, I guess. Maybe 1,000's alright. So let's just keep trying. So, just got my first rare drop, a clue scroll. I probably got some other rare drops, but my first good drop. So, a clue scroll, did I just DC? It's like, okay, so let's see what it is. Ooh, I can do that one, yep. Let's go do it now, actually, because Envy is pretty cool. Alright. Let's have a look. Okay, not the greatest. Not the greatest. So just got another clue scroll, let's see if we can do it. Looks like a wildy. How deep is that? That's like 20, 30, yeah, no, not doing it. Not for a first step anyway. Oh well, keep going. And there we have it, black mask. You know, this is the first time I've actually seen a purple text. I didn't even know if I had it on my OS buddy. I thought you had to do it custom. But that is very nice. It did not take too long, I mean, I've been here for most of the day, but that's very nice. Actually, let's go see how many kills it took. So, actually, I just banked not too long ago as well, 15 minutes ago. Okay, so I killed... What is it called again? Cave Horrors. Some reason for that. So 436, that's under the drop rate, so I definitely cannot complain. I'm very happy about that. Now, I do also need to get it imbued. Sorry, I also need to get it imbued, and there was something else I wanted to do. Oh yeah, get a fire cape. So I didn't quite get 76 range, but I guess I'll get that during the fire cape, so that's fine. So I'm going to do both those things in this episode, and then I'll think of something else. So just getting 73 strength. It's pretty good. I'm going to change to defense now, because I do want to get 70 in case I go back to barrows and get some armor. So I'll get 70 defense, and then I'm going to swap back to attack. So let's keep going. So just about to get 76 HP. Sadly, I've got Camille in this one, so this run's pretty much over. But that's fine. Let's keep going. Not too many points this one, but altogether I have 768, so still another 500 points to go. 500,000 points to go. Alright, I'm just going to leave. I've got a very bad spawn, but luckily, this will be enough points to let me imbue my black mask, so let's do it. Upgrades, imbue. And I still have 30,000 points in case I need to come back and imbue something else later. That's really nice. So now, I might actually try and do a fire cape. If I don't do it now, though, I'll do it later in the episode. But, yeah, I think I want to do it now. Have a look. So I think this is going to be my setup for Jad. I haven't done Jad in years, to be honest. Like, last time I did Jad, it would have been on my Pure, who had, like, 90 range, obviously one defense. And that was very easy, but I'm only 75 range on this guy, but I've also got defense levels. So it should be easy. I kind of remember how to do it. I've looked up the sound, so I know what the mage and range sound are again, because that's the one thing I wanted to remember. And everything else, I think, should just come back to me. So I'll probably come back at the last wave of fighting Jad. Alright, so I'm up to the second last wave. So let's see where Jad spawns. I think it's not a very good one. Oh, 76 range. Nice timing. Alright, so Jad's gonna be there, eh? Actually, that's not too bad. I think that's actually really good. I can go into that corner. And yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Perfect. Alright. I guess I'll fast forward this until I either die or get to Jad or something. Let's see. Yeah, okay, so he did spawn there. Alright, not bad. I was being so bad with my prayer pots, but I was just using all my prayers. Anyway, I've got two's more than enough. Alright, so let's do this. I probably shouldn't use this. Yeah, let's take it off for now. When healers come, I'll put it back on. Okay, let's go. Okay, I fucked up. I was trying to get to the safe spot, and I just totally... I'll use these. Alright, I've never actually killed the healers before. I've always just generally let them be. But you know what? They're in a very bad spot, so I'm just gonna kill them, see what happens. Hopefully they don't respawn. I don't actually know how that mechanic works. I think if Jad's on full HP, they respawn. But I think I stopped them before he got full HP. If not, I'm in trouble. Okay, I do not deserve this cape. That was actually atrocious. I made so many mistakes. Oh my god, that's pathetic. But, alright, I did get the cape. Apparently they said I deserve it, so... Okay, I guess now I can get really good Slayer gear. Hang on, let's have a look. So that's gonna be my Slayer gear. I have to say, that does not look too bad. I'll probably wear a Ring of Life, but... Still, I'm pretty happy with that, and I guess I'll either do Slayer or I'll think of something else to come back with.
So it was just AFK fishing before doing Slayer, and I didn't know I was that close to a level, so 75. One more for sharks, that's pretty nice. So I decided to do some more fishing before going off to Slayer, and that's 76 fishing, which is very nice. I can now try and catch sharks, but I won't do that yet. Before I do Slayer, I actually do want to get a really good house, and I think I will now have enough planks if I go to Miscellanea. So the next thing I want to do is get 67 construction, and then after that, the only other thing I want to do before I do Slayer is get that Koren teleport, and to do that I think I have to go into the library and try and find the book. So I'll do that, and then I'm going to start Slayer. So it won't be too far away.
Okay, so for 67 construction, I need about 1.1k more teaks, but I don't think I'm going to get that with it only being this high. So I'm going to take a few of herbs just for today. And I'm going to put it all on Teaks. Now, even if I have too much, then at least I can always come back and use them later. So that's fine. So, yep, let's just do it because I really want to get this done. So let's collect. And all right, I got way over, but that's fine. So I can use, I'll have some excess, which I'll just leave in the bank and I'll use later. And I still got, all right, not very good amount of herbs. Let's change it back. But at least I got enough takes now, so that's pretty good. So I was just doing a farm run and I realized that it's probably a good time to get my demon butler. So I've never done this before, but I'm pretty sure I just talked to him. So talk to him, you're hired. Perfect. I obviously built two bedrooms, and he's now going to be living with me, so that's fine, I guess. Let's go. So I've started the construction grind. I had about 5 mil when I started, and I've only been doing this for a while, but I've already got almost 500 planks, and it's relatively simple. The only hard thing is being in a PvP world, because I have to pay constant attention in case I misclick somewhere. But right now it's pretty simple. I just ask my servant to come, he says bring my logs to a sawmill, and I'm like, perfect. And then we just keep going. So I'll come back once I've made all my planks. I will have probably just over 2 mil or something when I'm done with everything. So that's not too bad, I guess. Alright, so this is the last invent. Let's have a quick look. So just under 2 mil, but that's not too bad. I still obviously have to pay him to bring my planks to me, but that's not a problem either. So I now have 330 mahogany planks and 4.5k teak. So it'll take a while, but at least now I can leave the PvP world. So let's go do that. 51 construction, but I'll do a quick montage for the rest of the levels. Alright, so here we finally are with 67 construction. I think I miscalculated a little bit because I have a couple of logs left over, but that's fine. A little bit extra construction experience isn't too bad. So now I can get the +5 boost and try and make a guild altar with the crystal saw on my inventory. But I'll just finish off these planks and then I guess I'll do that. So I've just finished using all the mahogany planks and I've got 1.7 mil left. I obviously have to still buy some of the gilded altar stuff, which is going to cost quite a bit. But I did use a bit more cash than I thought I would. I thought I'd still have about 2 mil left, but I really forgot how expensive mahogany planks were. So now I have to try and decide how I want my house layout to be. So I do want an altar there, I think that's pretty good, and the teleport there is good. I might move this room. I'm not 100% sure I'll do it, but I'll figure out a way. And I might come back with the parts that I'm gonna need for the house, like I think I need like marble and like a gold leaf for a few of those. I'll come back when I find out how to get those. So that's the plan for the moment. Alright, so I've looked over everything I need to buy, and it's going to be pretty expensive. So let's have a look. I need quite a few gold leaves, so I'll buy one. How much they got? 3k, okay, hang on. Then I need, oh, it's going to be so expensive, but I need it. Alright, but then I need marble blocks, I think. Yeah, so I need two marble blocks, so I'll buy one. Buy another gold leaf. How many gold leaves do I need? I need one. I need 5 gold leaves altogether. Okay. I'm just gonna hop worlds because I'm pretty cheap. So that's pretty much my entire cash stack gone, which is pretty sad, but at least I've got everything I need now. So I'll meet you back at the house with my 343k and the other supplies I need. Alright, so I think I've got everything I need for the beginning part of my construction. I obviously still need the +5 boost. Oh, whoops, wrong mode, hang on. I obviously still need to get the +5 boost if I want to make the gilded altar and the crystal saw. But for the moment, I will make the burners, which I think you can use any. I'm just gonna do these ones because I have some mahoganies left over. Oh, it does both. Oh, that's nice. Okay then, I got X spare, but that's fine. And then I need to make this eagle thing for my house tabs. Sure I get the right one, pretty sure it's that one. Nice, and now the rest is for my guild altar, but I need to go get the boost, so let's go try and get it.
Alright, so I think I have all the supplies now to make the Gilded Altar. This might take a while because of the fact that I can't hop worlds and I have to be very careful with the plus 5 boost. Let's have a look.
Two lumber blocks. Yep. Gold leaves. Yep. And water buff. Yep. Alright, so let's try and get this boost. Wow, I got it, and that was not too bad. I've been quite lucky with my boosts, I have to say. Right, so I think that's everything for my house now. I can't think of anything else I need. I obviously want to get a Corend teleport over here, but that will be... Actually, I'll probably do that later this episode. Let's have a look. Study. I can make house tabs, right? Yep, perfect. Alright, so... I guess the next thing I'm going to do is probably go to Corend, or Zazea, sorry, and try and get that book to find the teleport to make the house thing, to make the house portal. Alright, that's the next plan.
Okay, so I've decided that I want to get 100% Arkea's favor. I might not do it all this episode, I just want to do it until I at least find the Corend teleport book. But it's a good idea to do it because I want to eventually make Barrow tabs, and... I need 100% favor, I'm pretty sure, to do that. So I think this is the first one I'm handing in. And that got me 1.5 experience in Arceus, but it lost me Shazayan. But that's fine. I don't think I'm ever going to get 100% in Shazayan anyway. So I'll keep going until I've either found the book or I've got lots of favor. Oh, wow. So I actually found the transportation book. So do I just read it and then do I learn it? You have learnt the teleport to Corend. Oh, very nice. So, I guess really I'm kind of done here. Well, I might as well just use this experience because I probably will take a break. So, I'll use it on runecrafting because I think I'm pretty close. There's also 55 runecrafting. Very nice. And now I guess I'll go make the teleport in my house. So, I'll go get the runes and do that. Okay, so I'm just going to make the teleport for my house. So, I forgot how to do this, right? So, do this. Number two. This one. Perfect. So now, all these three places take me places I really want to go. And I might build another transportation room later, but for the moment, I think that's fine. And this should take me straight to... Yeah, perfect. So if I'm doing Slayer, I can just teleport here and then go straight in. So now the next thing I want to do is start making some house tabs, so when I am on Lunas, I can still get to my house to teleport here. I think I'll make maybe 150, so I need 150 soft clay, so I'll go mine that first. So I've mined enough clay now, so I'm going to make them into soft clay at Lumbridge, and I still only want to make 150, I've got a few more, but 150 is a good number, I think. And then I guess I'll meet you at Yanil after I've made 150 soft clay. Alright, so I've got all my soft clay ready. So now I just have to make 150 house tabs, which I think I just have to do this, and it's relatively simple. I'm not sure how long it takes though for one. It's not too bad. Alright, I'll come back when I made all 150. Alright, so I've just finished making my teleport to houses, which was pretty helpful. I now will just store them in my bank and put them pretty much near the top. Sadly, I have like no cash left, but I do have a lot of battle starves that I can still alk. So I probably will make some battle starves and alk them. And then I'm not too sure what I want to do. I might just finally be able to start Slayer again. First off, though, I'm going to make some more battle starves and just alk them so I have some cash. Okay, so I'm going to end the episode here. We got quite a bit done this episode. I mean, not as much as maybe the last couple of videos, but those were some really grinding videos. But we did get our 67th construction, which is nice for the house. And I think I've got everything I now need to do Slayer. I got the Black Mask, Fire Cape... house teletabs when I'm on Luna, because I don't have Slayer rings yet, so being on Lunas will be the easiest, then going for my house will be good teleportation-wise. So I guess next episode my goal is probably going to be Slayer rings, because that's my big next objective, and it'll be really, really helpful for Slayer. So thanks for watching, I now have enough cash to buy battle stabs every day for quite a while, and I'll see you next time.